Hello everybody, how are you? It's me, Uphosha Shabalala. I'm back again with yet another amazing Bible scripture reading. Amen. Hallelujah, we are on reading number 4. I think as we begin Advent, we'll start to see a lot more readings from me as I also begin to wind down the year. And as we all await the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, through his birth on Christmas Day. Are we excited? I'm very excited. Thank you. Oh my Lord, so, you know, today at Mass, I found myself contemplating around the principle where we as Christians say, for the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, yeah? We say this as a responsorial in my church all the time. We find this also in our prayers and also in our scripture. We say, for the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours. You know, and today, you know, I found myself thinking, what exactly does that look like in our daily lives as Christians? Right? What does God's kingship look like in my life? And what does God's power look like in my life? And how do I show his glory? How does his glory reflect in my life? Amen. And of course, as you know, my journey with God is based on scripture. So I went back to the history books and studied the history of David, the king of Israel, as you know, which is really where we find this outrageous declaration that the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours. We find it at the time when David, chanted a prayer in assembly. Remember in Israel? Yes. So I thought I'm going to read that today to us, to just get us to reflect as to what David was saying in prayer to God. Why was he saying, for the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours? Of course, you know that this happened at the time, just before, you know, the temple was going to be erected. At the time, all the resources required had been gathered for the building of the temple. And of course, it had all of his kinsmen, you know, his soldiers, his family, his followers in assembly. And of course, he chanted what we now know today as David's prayer. We find this prayer, of course, as always, I have my Catholic Study Bible. Please open up your Christian Bible as well as we are about to begin reading. I'm going to read for us from the first book of Chronicles, chapter 29, verse 10, and I will go up to verse 19. Yes, from the first book of Chronicles, chapter 29, verse 10 to verse 19, where we are going to reflect and read David's prayer at the assembly, because it is in this prayer that he said, for the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours. Amen. So let us read. Then David blessed the Lord in the sight of the whole assembly. David said, blessed are you, Lord God of Israel, our Father, from eternity to eternity. Yours, Lord, are greatness and might, majesty, victory, and splendor. For all in heaven and on earth is yours. Yours, Lord, is kingship. You are exalted as head over all. Riches and glory are from you, and you have dominion over all. In your hand are power and might. It is yours to give greatness and strength to all. Therefore, our God, we give you thanks, and we praise the majesty of your name. But who am I, and who are my people, that we should have the means to contribute so freely? For everything is from you, and what we give is what we have from you. For before you, we are strangers and travelers, like all our ancestors. Our days on earth are like a shadow without a future. Lord our God, all this wealth that we have brought together to build you a house for your holy name comes from you and is entirely yours. I know, my God, that you put hearts to the test and that you take pleasure in integrity. With the whole heart, I have willingly given all these things. And now with joy, I have seen your people here present, also giving to you generously. Lord God of our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, keep such thoughts in the hearts and minds of your people forever, and direct their heart toward you. Give to my son Solomon a wholehearted desire to keep your commandments, precepts, and statutes, that he may carry out all these plans and build the palace for which I have made preparation. Oh my Lord, hallelujah, amen, for the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours. Oh my goodness, you know, I want you to go back and spend time with the scripture. You know, if you have more time, go back a few chapters back and study really the history of how David came into his kingship, and how he got to this moment, to this epic moment where he was now ready to build the house of the Lord. For me, you know, it speaks to all of our belongings, all of our earthly belongings are not ours. You know, God gave us the resources, but only for us to give them back to him, right? For the kingdom and the power and the glory is his, amen? Yeah, so I thought, you know what, let me reflect on this today and share the scripture and leave it with you to contemplate for yourself what this means and how it relates to you and your life, amen? Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. This is the share for today, amen. Thank you.